Hello, Susan Young here. In this video, I will be covering 10 biggest mistakes shopaholics make when paying off debt. Ten biggest mistakes of shopaholics make when paying off debt. The decision to get yourself out of debt is a life changer if you are willing to make the necessary commitment that goes with that. You can learn how to get out of debt and how to avoid the mistakes that would torpedo the whole thing. Getting out of debt involves more than just paying off a few credit cards. It means changing spending habits, learning how to budget, knowing who and how much you owe, prioritizing debts, creating emergency and retirement funds, and knowing where to find help when you get off track. In other words, there are a lot of decisions that need to be made, and it's possible, if not probable, you'll make some mistakes along the way. Here are some you can avoid that will make it easier to get out of debt. Mistake number one, same old spending habits. People are creatures of habits, and spending money is no exception. We shop at the same stores, eat in the same restaurants, and drive the same car because it's comfortable. It's also costing you more than you can handle financially. Remedy: if you won't change your spending habits, you won't ever get out of debt. Start with your morning habits. Have your coffee and breakfast at home. Go to lunch with a brown bag, not a wallet. In the evening, watch games or movies on TV while eating a home-cooked meal. You will see an immediate impact on your daily spending habits. You don't have to do without. You just have to make better choices with what you do. Mistake number two, trying to dig out of debt alone. People are reluctant to ask relatives or friends for help dealing with debt. Remedy: call a nonprofit credit counseling agency and get free help from experts. Credit counselors are trained and certified by national organizations like the NFCC or National Foundation for Credit Counseling. They can suggest debt relief solutions like debt management programs, credit consolidation, debt settlement, or if things are way over the edge, bankruptcy. The credit counselors advise you on credit budgets and recommend a solution that you can take or leave, and it's free. Take advantage of that. Mistake number three, signing up for a debt relief program but not understanding what is expected. It is rare to get a quick fix solution to debt problems. If that is one of the promises you hear, start looking elsewhere. Remedy: the first thing to understand is that debt relief programs typically take 3 to 5 years, so be patient. Second, check up on the whatever company you choose for debt relief. The Better Business Bureau or local state attorney's office are good places to start. Credit unions, universities, and military bases should be reliable sources for recommendations. Be sure whatever organization you choose is licensed and doesn't have a record of consumer complaints. Mistake number four, not creating a practical budget. It is difficult, if not impossible, to gain control of your finances unless you have a budget. People think it's too much work until they get $20,000 in credit card debt and wonder how in the world that happened. Remedy: develop a realistic budget that addresses financial needs like housing, food, healthcare, insurance, and education, but still creates room to make payments on debt. put away the credit cards and only pay with cash. That might mean reducing or eliminating things like dining out, entertainment, shopping for new clothes, cars, or electronics. But if you're serious about eliminating debt, operating with a budget and paying cash is a great start. Mistake number 5, trying to pay off multiple debts at once. Consumers with multiple sources of debt, credit cards, mortgage, student loans, etc., often try and address each one every month. Bad move. Remedy: go back to your budget. Trim spending to bare bones on everything but essentials and create a $100 or preferably $1,000 surplus that goes directly at the credit card with the highest interest rate. When that's paid off, go after the card with the next highest interest rate and keep going until all credit cards debt is eliminated. How are you doing with this video so far? If you like this video, hit the like button below. Mistake number 6, closing accounts when they are paid off. Remedy: the solution to this problem is simple. Pay off the account, but don't close it. The credit scoring systems rely not only on how much money you owe, but how much credit you have available. Having credit available but not using it shows restraint and can improve your score. Mistake number 7. You decide to stop contributing to a retirement account. While it seems to make sense to devote every dollar possible to eliminating debt today, in the long run, it's a costly mistake. Remedy: contribute at least 5% to 10% of your income to retirement savings as soon as you begin working, and don't let eliminating debt cut into that. Time is the most powerful tool in retirement savings. The earlier you start contributing to a 401k or other retirement fund, the better off you'll be at retirement. Find other places in your budget to pay down credit card accounts. Mistake number 8, not setting aside emergency savings. According to research, more than half of American consumers, 57%, don't have enough cash to cover an unexpected expense of $500 or more. Remedy: it's impossible to predict unemployment, car accidents, or busted plumbing, which is why every home needs an emergency fund. Experts say put 3 to 6 months of expenses aside for emergencies. It might take a while to get there if you're focused on paying off debt, but again, it has to be part of your monthly budget. Set aside at least 5% of your income in an emergency fund, at least until you have 3 months of expenses covered. Mistake number 9, not verifying your credit report is correct. Checking your credit report for inaccuracies is an important step in your journey to reduce your debt. Remedy: you are allowed a free credit report from each of the major credit reporting bureaus. Split them up, one every 4 months. Check them closely for inaccurate delinquencies and/or balances that hurt your credit score and could make a difference in your ability to buy a house or car or obtain more credit. Mistake number 10, not prioritizing your debt. Everyone has bills, and most everyone wants to get out of debt, but some people simply can't get focused. It's not a priority for them. Remedy: the best solution could be to consolidate your debts and make just one payment every month. Another way to get focused would be to take a piece of paper the size of a credit card and write down the 5 debts you want to get rid of. Tape that piece of paper to your credit card. Every time you reach for that card, you'll be reminded that you're adding, not subtracting, to the problems of that page. Question of the day. Shopaholics, what mistakes do you make when paying off debt? Feel free to share below. check out my website at www.stopbigspending.com. Leave me your email address at the Contact Us page on the website, and I will inform you on my next videos coming up and give you great tips. My next video I will be covering, Shopaholics Surviving a Cash Crisis. How are you doing so far with this video? If you like this video, hit the like button below. See you later this week here on YouTube, and see you on social media. You have a great week.